Hello everyone, we are here today to learn how to build the RB300 model rocket. This is your RB300 model rocket kit. You can buy it right off of our website on our e-store. I've given a link in the description below. And to all the rocketeers who've already got their kit and are excited to build it, let's get started. And the first thing that I'm going to be doing is that I'm going to be opening up this kit and showing you all the materials that are there inside and classifying them. So let's get started. My first step is opening up this box. So wow, so many things inside this kit. It took me a long time to set everything up. Oh, I'm still not done. So I'm going to be finally opening your fins. So these are very, very fragile components. They're made out of balsa. That's why we put them in foam separately. Be very careful with them. You can break them. I'm using my own paper cutter. We've given you one in the kit. So yeah guys, let's now get started. So I'll first introduce you to all the materials in the kit. First over here, you have a letter from us telling you more about Rocketeers, telling you what all you can do, what all you can see on the internet. We've given you QR codes to different places that we've created on the internet, some interesting videos and experiences. We also tell you about how to select the flying zone for your rocket, what are the safe ways of flying and so on. So that's the first thing. Then over here, I have everything that you need to build one RB300 rocket. So these are all the components that you will require to make sure that you can completely build your rocket, and I'm going to introduce them one by one. So first over here we have a sticker. This will give you the look and the branding for RB300. This will make sure that your rocket looks all missile-y, and since it's inspired by missiles. Then we have over here centering rings. We have got four of them. They are made out of PVC foam. They are called centering rings. They help us center your rocket engine along with the body tube. So they make sure that your rocket engine or your motor is in the center of the body tube. Then we have over here these smaller ones. These are called block rings. They block your motor into the rocket. They make sure that it cannot escape the rocket and it stays attached along with the rocket. So as your motor goes up, or as your rocket engine goes up and as it fires, it takes the rocket along. So these are called the block rings. They are made out of the same material as the centering rings, the PVC foam. Then over here, we have something called the motor housing. So this is the housing where your rocket engine goes inside. So that is why it is called the motor housing. And then we have the body tube of the rocket. So this tube is the main body of the rocket. And along with that, we have this one component that you've not seen in rockets up till now. This is called an adapter. So this basically is designed for you to adapt the diameter of your rocket from one diameter to another. So if you have two different body tubes, or two different, like your nose cone is of a different diameter than your body tube, this adapter helps you adapt your diameter to the correct size. So I'll show you how to use this. So all of these three components, they are made out of Sackcraft paper. Now Also, to attach these components, especially the adapter, we have a bunch of extra things. So over here, we have these small clips. So we have got 6 of them. They are called dia reduction clip. So they are basically used to reduce the diameter of a larger body tube to a smaller one. And then we have over here these 3 discs. They are called the adapter discs. So you will need only one of them. We've given you 2-3 different sizes, so you can experiment with the different shapes and so on, and see how these things work. You will only need this one today. So these are called adapter discs. Apart from this, we also have a launch lug. So this is a very, very important component. You need to fix it very properly with the rocket. This component ensures that your rocket stays attached with the launch pad before launch. So when it is launching, the rocket rises along the launch rod. This launch lug makes sure that your rocket stays attached to that launch rod. We also have this. This is the HDPE nose cone. You've seen this before for smaller rockets. We've got this one for RP-300. It's designed to be of the correct diameter. And this is made out of HDPE and it is blow molded. And last but not the least, we have your Rocketeer's C-Class Black Powder Model Rocketry Motor. And we have its igniter. So we made sure that we've given you these 2 components so that you can fly your rocket safely and reliably. Next up, we have all the tools that you will need to build your rocket. So we've got electric tape, we've got a paper cutter, we've got a scissor, we've got Fevikwik, and we've got sandpaper. So these are all the tools that you will need to be able to build your rocket properly. Apart from this, we also have this. We have this string. This is called the lasso string. This is masquerading as the packaging. It is used to tie up all the components together when we are packing them. But this is not a part of the packaging. This is actually a very important component. This will help you conduct your stability test, which is a very, very important safety procedure that you have to follow before every launch. So it is very important that you keep this string safe. Do not cut it. It is required to conduct the stability test. We also have over here the fin sheet. So this sheet is there inside your kit. This will help you understand where to put your fins, where to put your launch lug, what is the correct position, and so on. So this is also an important piece of paper, and this also is a building tool that comes along inside the kit. Apart from this, we've given a bunch of extra components. We know that sometimes some things break, sometimes you want to fly a rocket again, and you want to experiment with different stuff. So we've given a bunch of extra things as a part of our DIY kit. The first thing that is there is this igniter. I showed you this before with the motor. This is a single-use component. So in case you're launching your rocket and there is a misfire and your motor does not ignite, or you're testing out your ignition system and your first igniter is used, you have the second one available. So this can be used to ignite your motor properly the second time and make sure that you can launch within the same day. And that is why we've given 2 of them, one for the first use and one for the second use, within our DIY kit. We have also given an extra fin. I showed you these 4 fins before. So in this pack, we have 4 fins. So these are made out of balsa wood. Balsa wood is the lightest wood in the world. So we've got 4 of them for your rocket. We've also given you 1 extra fin. So this extra fin is there in case you break one of your 4 fins or one of them gets damaged. So this extra fin is there so that you can replace it, even though these fins are very, very repairable. In case your fins break, you can stick them back together with Fevikwik. But still, we've given 1 extra. Apart from that, we've given you 3 extra motor housings to be able to fly your rocket again, put new motors into it. 2 of these motor housings are compatible with the B-class motor. The motor that you are getting with this rocket is a C-class motor. It is bigger than this, as you can see. So 2 of these are for a B-class motor. We've given you extra centering rings as well for both B-class and C-class motors. We've given you extra block rings as well for both B-class and C-class motors. We've given you a bunch of extra dia reduction clips. And we've given you extra adapter discs. So all of these components come as an extra within the kit in case you damage something, in case something gets lost, and so on. So you have all the components available as an extra so that you can make sure to build your RB300 completely and fly and get the best launching experience possible. And last but not the least, we have the packaging. So this has four plastic fins and one big box. These plastic fins go onto these blue lines that you can see over here. So there are white marker lines over here which these fins get attached to. And this box becomes a nice little souvenir for your room. You can see one over here. So it becomes like this. And it looks nice in your room and you can show the world that you're a rocketeer. We also have given within the kit this instruction manual. So this instruction manual has all the safety instructions that you need to follow. These safety instructions are very, very important. You need to make sure that you follow each one of them to the letter. They give you proper safeguards and protocols on how to properly launch a model rocket. Please stay safe while doing this activity. Do not hurt yourself or others around you. Then it has the list of components, it has a set of instructions that you need to follow to build out your rocket. So it has all the instructions that you need. And once you've built out your rocket, this is a booklet that sort of becomes useless for most kids. And we did not want that. We wanted to make sure that this does not get thrown into the dustbin and we don't waste this much paper. And we are also giving you instructions on video, so some of the students may not even be using this. So that is why we converted it into a poster. We applied some little bit of design thinking to this and folded it in an interesting way. So when you open it up, it opens like this. And it becomes a poster. So this is, I am sure all of you excited rocketeers about space would love to have a poster like this in your bedroom. You can see we have got so many of them. One over here, there are others around. So it converts into a poster just like these. Every rocketeer who gets a RB300 gets this poster. You can put it up in your bedroom and showcase to the world your excitement about space, and at the same time learn a lot. These posters are very educational and they give you a lot of information about various aspects of space exploration. So now this was all the components in the RB300 kit. Next up, let's start building. So the first thing that I'm going to do is that I'm going to start fixing my plastic fins to my box to make it look like this. So for that, I'll take the paper cutter and I will start cutting small slits into these white markers that are there on the blue lines. So you should do this very, very carefully. Do not hurt yourself, do not cut yourself. This is a little difficult activity. So we are going to take a paper cutter and we are going to cut a hole in each one of these white colored markers. So be very, very careful with the paper cutter. We do not want you to hurt yourself. So see, I've cut out two holes into the one side of this tube and I can straight off fix my fin onto it like this. So once I fix this fin, I'm going to repeat this step four times and get a box like this one. So now that I've completed this, let's get to the next step. Let's start building the RB300. So the first step that I'm going to do is that I'm going to put the sticker onto the body tube. It's one of the easier things to do. So for that, first I'm going to peel off this sticker sheet from the sticker. And then I'm going to keep this on my table flat like this, such that the sticky side is on the top. So as you can see, it sticks to my fingers. So the sticky side is on top. Then I'm going to align it approximately near the center of my body tube and straight. And then I'm going to just tightly roll it onto my body tube, making sure that there are no wrinkles, there are no air gaps, It's just perfectly tightly rolled onto the body tube like this. So with that, I'll leave this aside and get to the next step. So the next step is assembling your motor housing. So the motor housing assembly is very, very important. It makes sure that your rocket engine or your motor gets centered to the rocket and at the same time is perfectly aligned with the axis and does not detach from the rocket when you are building, when you are launching it. So for that, I will need this motor housing, I will need two of the block rings, and I will need four of these centering rings. First, I will take the two block rings and stick them together. I will do the same with the centering rings. Stick two of them together and two of them together separately. So for that, I will be using Fevikwik. We've given you one in the kit. I have this one open already, so I'm going to use that and I'm going to start sticking all of this together. So, one drop, two drops, three drops, and four drops. When I'm sticking these together, I should make sure that they are perfectly aligned, center to center. They should not be misaligned, they should be perfectly aligned, they should look like a polo. So as you can see, I've stuck these two block rings together. In the same way, I'm going to be sticking two centering rings. They should also be perfectly aligned, center to center. So one drop, two drops, three drops, and four drops. In case you feel that they have not stuck properly and you need to add some Fevikwik somewhere, just add a drop along the edge in between the rings, just making sure that it gets fixed properly. So this is what I've done with this set of centering rings. I felt that it was not stuck properly, so I just added some more Fevikwik on the sides between the rings, and now they're stuck properly together. In the same way, I'll be repeating this with the other two rings. And do not worry about getting Fevikwik on your hands. I am getting Fevikwik on my hands too. This is a DIY activity. Things like that is a part and parcel of that. So you have to get your hands dirty and it'll be a little rough. Fevikwik is just glue. You can wash it off later. For now, enjoy building the rocket. So now I've stuck these two together as well. In case you make a mistake and you stick these rings in a misaligned manner, just keep them aside. We've given you a bunch of extra. Do it correctly. They should be aligned properly. They should stick together properly. So now I have two sets like this and one like this, and I have my motor housing. So now let's start assembly. So the first thing that I'm going to do is that from one side of my motor housing, I'm going to insert the block ring into the motor housing. As you can see that this is a snug fit. Very nicely, it just fits over there properly. So like this, I'm going to push this in a little inside. So to measure how inside it should go, I'm going to use my rocket engine or my motor, and I'm going to insert it from the other side, and I'm going to insert the exact full length so it is flush with the motor housing. So you can see right now it is just flush with the motor housing, and then based on that I have the position of my centering rings. So they are touching each other now. I have the position of my block rings. They are touching each other now. So now I'm going to stick these block rings in place, and I'm going to use Fevikwik again. For that, I will put Fevikwik along the periphery where the block rings and the motor housing meet. And I'm going to press it from the outside just to make sure that it's stuck in place. I'm going to take out my motor. I'm going to stick these block rings properly in place. Next, I'm going to insert one of the sets of the centering rings. So I inserted the block ring and stuck them over here on this side. So on the other side, the empty side, I'm going to put my centrifugal. So I can see that this is very, very loose. So as you can see, this is a very, very loose fit. I want to make sure that this is a tight and a snug fit. So for that, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take some electric tape. We've given you one complete roll in the kit. So I have this one open already. I'm going to take some, I'm going to open it up. And I'm going to roll one layer of this electric tape onto the edge. So as you can see, I've rolled this electric tape onto the edge of my motor housing. And I'm going to use my paper cutter again. We've given you one in the kit. So I'm going to use this and I'm going to cut this off. Again, be very, very careful. Do not cut your fingers. Be safe. Young children do this activity in the supervision of your parents. Children below the age of 10 years especially do this in the presence of your parents. So as you can see, I have made a layer of electric tape over here. And now let's insert this again. So I can feel that this is tighter already, but it's still loose. So I will add another layer. So one more layer of electric tape like this. So now I've added another layer of this electric tape to the motor housing. I'm going to stick this. I'm going to try and check this again. It is still not tight enough. So now I'm going to add another layer of electric tape. Even after adding two layers, I can still feel that it is loose. So I'll add another layer like this. Yeah. Be very, very careful while cutting this off. Do not hurt yourself. Do not cut yourself. Young children do this under the supervision of your parents. Now I added three layers of tape to this. Now I can feel it. It's properly snug and tight. So as you can see over here, it's properly snug and tight. So it doesn't shake off. So just to show you the difference, I put this without the electric tape. So it's shaking like this. This one is not shaking. If I hold it like this, so you can see that this is now snugly fit, whereas this one is not. And we needed three layers for this. So we'll have to repeat this same three layers at another position where we are fixing this ring. But for now, let's start with this ring. So I'll keep it near, very near to the edge of the motor housing. So on this side I have the block rings, on this side I have the tape, and I have kept the centering rings very, very close to the edge of the motor housing. They are practically flush with the edge of the motor housing. And now I'm going to stick these centering rings in place over here using Fevikwik. So again, I will apply Fevikwik to the region between the centering rings and the motor housing along the edge, just to stick it in place. So I've added a good amount of Fevikwik, but not too much. It should not drip off. It should not create a layer. It should be drop by drop so that it just holds your centering ring in place. So I'm sticking it all together properly, nicely and snugly. It should fit. Now I know that to fit it snugly, I needed approximately three layers of tape. So, and I need to fix the other set of rings over here on the other side. So, for that, I will again repeat the same process. I will look at the position of the block rings. So, you know, look at the position of the block rings and I will add tape on exactly that position. So, I will open up this tape and I will start putting it where the block rings are. So, exactly on the same position, I will add three layers. 1, 2, and 3. So, this should add exactly in the same thickness as the bottom side. Now, I will just cut this off. Again, by cutting it off, be very careful. Do not hurt yourself. Do not cut yourself. Be very careful while using paper cutter or scissors. Now, I will insert these to the other side and I will stick them exactly in place where the block rings are. So, again I will add some Fevikwik. Exactly at the place where the block rings are. You should stick it very, very properly. So as you can see, I've added one more layer on top. So there may be some small misalignments and tolerances between the motor housing and the centering rings at times. And so you may need to add an extra layer of tape here and there. So like that, I've added one more layer on the top because my ring was still loose. It wasn't sticking properly. And now I can feel, yes, it's much more properly, snugly in place. So I will just take it to the correct position, right above the centering rings. Right above the block rings. So the position of my centering ring is exactly the same as the position of my block rings, like this. And now I will stick it into place. So I will add some Fevikwik. And stick it in place very, very properly, making sure it cannot move. And I will keep it to dry. So this is the complete assembly of my motor housing. So this is the complete assembly. It includes the centric rings, it includes the motor housing, and it includes the block rings. So this is one segment of the assembly that is now complete. Next up, we have the adapter. So this adapter is very, very useful for you to ensure that whenever you need to change the diameter of your rocket, you have a component that helps you do that. So if you look over here, this is your body tube, but this is your nose cone. Up till now, all the rockets that you've built, all the level 1 rockets that we saw till now, they used to have the nose cone which used to get fixed directly. But this is like, if I try and put this on over here, it just falls off. This is, so you have a huge gap over here. So this gap needs to be addressed. This is the adapter that will help you do this. So it will help you fix this nose cone to this body tube. This body tube is approximately 4 centimeters in diameter. We've given you a scale in the kit so you can measure for yourself. So this is approximately 4 centimeters in diameter and your nose cone is 3 centimeters in diameter. We're not giving you a vernier caliper, I'm just showing it to you on that over here. So yeah, it shows 29.7. So you, as you can see, the 0.3 mm difference is just a tolerance difference. So it's basically 3 centimeters. So 3 centimeters to 4 centimeters we have to fix. Now, if you look at this adapter, if you try and insert the nose cone on the top, this is too big. The nose cone is too big. The adapter top is too small, and if you try and put it on the body tube, you'll see again the adapter is too big. the body tube is smaller in diameter. So what is happening over here? Let's see. Let's measure the adapter and we will find out. So as you can see, the adapter is 2 centimeters on top and it is 4.5 centimeters at the bottom. You can again measure it yourself. It is 2 centimeters on the top, 4.5 centimeters on the bottom. Let's see what's the height. So if I measure it like this, it shows me 9.85 or approximately 10 centimeters in height. So 9.85 centimeters or 10 centimeters, 1 mm or 1.5 mm again is a tolerance value for a component like this on a model rocket. So it's 10 centimeters on in height, 2 centimeters in diameter over here, 4.5 centimeters in diameter at the bottom. We have a body tube of 4 centimeter dia and a nose cone of 3 centimeter dia. So we need to cut this so that the top becomes 3 centimeter and then we need to cut it from the bottom so that the bottom becomes 4 centimeter. 3 centimeter on top, 4 centimeter on the bottom. 3 centimeters on the top, 4 centimeters on the bottom. So when I say the height is 10 centimeters, I mean vertical height, not the length of the side. I mean the vertical height of the cone is 10 centimeters. I have measured it using a vernier caliper. So if you see, on a vernier caliper you have this stick. The stick is usually used to measure depth. So if I put it like this and I get the scale to the height of the cone, I get the vertical height, which is 10 centimeters. So 10 centimeters high. So we need to make sure that the top diameter of the cone becomes, of the adapter becomes 3 centimeter and the bottom diameter of the adapter becomes 4 centimeter. So for that we need to cut it. So we've made it really, really easy for all of you students. The formula that you are going to use is 4x minus 80. 4x minus 80, where x is the diameter that you need and all dimensions are in mm. So for a let's start with the bottom side. On the bottom side, we need 4 centimeters. So 4 centimeters means 40 mm. And 40 mm, if we put that into the formula, 4 into 40 is 160, minus 80 is equal to 80. So 80 mm, we get this value of 80 mm. We are going to measure it like this, along the side now. So along the side, when you measure 80 mm, that is like 8 centimeters. So if you measure it like this, it's 8 centimeters and what I will do is that I will take a pen and mark 8 centimeters over here. I have given you a pen in the kit, I've got one here, so I'm using this. So I've marked 8 centimeters here, then I'm going to take up another spot. Make sure that my scale is aligned along the length. So even the side is approximately 10 centimeters because it's a very, very steep angle. So the hypotenuse is approximately equal to the length of the hypotenuse is approximately equal to the length of the height. So now again, 4x minus 80 means 8 centimeters from the top over here. I have marked.
Mark at multiple points.
So I am marking at 4 or 5 points so that I get them across the adapter. So I have marked 8 centimeter points. So I have marked 4 or 5 8 centimeter points across the adapter. Now what I will do is that I will carefully with my hand complete this into a circle. So make sure that your circular marking lies in the same plane. So yeah, so I've got my markings here. So as you can see, I've got my markings here on the adapter. Now what I will do is that I will take the paper cutter and start cutting along the markings. Be very, very careful. Do not cut your fingers. Young students, please do this in adult supervision. Take the help of your parents.
Hold your hand steady and then.
So hold your hand steady and insert it. Insert the paper cutter into the adapter. Just a little bit. You don't need to apply the full cut in the first circumference. First, just mark the full cut. So yeah, I've marked the full cut along the circumference of the adapter. Now I will start cutting along this mark. And like this, I have made a proper cut to the full adapter. There might be rough edges, you need to clean them up. So for that, I will be using a scissor. We've given you one in the kit, and I will just clean up the complete edge. So these small neatness sort of things which you are careful about makes the aerodynamics of your rocket better. It makes sure that you can attach everything together very cleanly and overall improves the performance of your rocket. Even if I did not clean this edge and just assemble the rocket, it would probably still fly. But I want to have the best launch experience and I want you guys to have the same. And that is why I'll be very, very careful. I will do this neatly. I will take my time. Instead of spending half an hour on building it, I'll spend 1.5 hours. But I'll make sure that I make a nice, well-performing model rocket. So this is something similar that starts happening as you start scaling up and become building more and more complex rockets. This is the kind of thing that improves quality. So you have to be very, very careful about each and every component. Make sure that it is working in the right way. So now, as you can see, my edge is all clean and my adapter is at the bottom approximately 4 centimeters in diameter. Let's see, let's put it on this tube and see if it fits nicely. And yeah, it's perfect. They align in diameter, as you can see. It's aligning on all sides. It's like it has become a part of the tube. So this is where we are going to fix this adapter. So it's now properly aligning with the body tube of RB300. So now this is done. Now on the top side, we need to convert it into a 3 centimeter diameter cone. And we all remember the formula, right? 4x minus 80. So our x is this time 30. So 4 into 30 is 120 minus 80 is 40. So now I will measure 40 mm from the top on all 4 or 5 sides, make those markings, convert the markings into a circle and make the cut. So the same process like we did the last time. So let's get started. So first I will start by marking 120 minus 80, 40. So 4 centimeters. So yeah, I have marked my 4 centimeter line. Just going to increase the length of all the markings a little bit. Checking if it's in the same plane. See, I have some markings in the plane that's off. So I'm a little careful about making sure that I follow the correct line, not the mark on top, but the same plane line. And now I mark that. So I'll make this cut. I will repeat the same process. First, I will reinforce that mark using my paper cutter, and then I will cut along the mark. Be very, very careful. Do not hurt yourself. Done. So now along that mark, I will start. Correct. So now I'll fit my nose cone on top. And as you can see, it fits properly, but my edge is still very, very dirty. So to improve the quality, I will start fixing my edge just like I did the last time. Also, be careful to close your paper cutter blade every time you're not using it, so that it cannot cut you or hurt you. So with this, I have completed the cutting of my adapter cone. I've cleaned up the edges, made them all nice and smooth. The nose cone fits on top, and the body tube fits perfectly on the bottom. Next steps. So, as you can see, we've got these components over here. Let's keep all of this aside. I'll clean my station a little bit. It's much easier to work in an organized fashion. I recommend you all do the same. We've given you all of these extra components that I told you about in the beginning. There is an adapter disc, and there are 6 dia reduction clips. Now, why are they called dia reduction? This is the dia of your body tube, and then your nose cone is smaller. The adapter is reducing the dia from here to here. So your diameter is reducing along the length. This clip helps you achieve that. Also, if you look at this adapter disc, it is of the exact size of your body tube. So now, the first step that we are going to do is, we are going to put these dia reduction clips onto this adapter disc. So I'll put them all 6 onto the adapter disc. While doing this, you have to be very, very careful. So if you notice, all the edges along the bottom are straight, and all the edges along the top are moving towards the inside. All the edges at the bottom are straight and all the edges at the top are moving inside. So if I put this clip wrong, like this, you'll be able to see the difference. So this is moving inside, this is straight, this is also straight, this is moving inside. So I have to correct it, I have to make sure that they are aligned properly and all the clips with the edge moving inside are in the same alignment. So all the edges are moving inside and all the edges are straight. So now this is a small assembly that we have made. This is a component that will help you assemble both of these other components together. So this is your structure in between. This needs to be stuck together again with Fevikwik. So I have mine over here. We've given you one in the kit and I will just apply some Fevikwik to each one of these clips. So I will apply along the edges between the clip and the adapter disc so that the adapter disc and the clip stick together. So it's along the edges, it's seeping it into the edges. I'll let this dry for a while. Now I'll get to my next step. So which is assembling this adapter disc with the body tube. So if you see, this inserts here perfectly and your nose, your adapter can rest on top of this. For this, first we will put this here and see it assembles like this. It locks over here perfectly into the adapter. I cannot push it in further and can come out. If I want to try and push it in, it doesn't go in because my disc is too big. The diameter of the adapter is reducing. It does not go all the way in. Now, what I'm going to do is, as my first step, I will apply Fevikwik on all of these edges and stick this over here like this. This will make sure that I can put this on like this. So the other way to do it also is to stick this assembly to the body tube and then stick the adapter on. Both of these methods are correct. Basically, at the end of it, all of these three components will act as a single structure. So you have to assemble them together, stick them in properly, make sure that they're straight and sturdy. So I'll begin. I'm going to follow this path where I'm going to stick this over here and then I'm going to put the adapter on top. Let's begin. Again, don't worry about getting Fevikwik on your fingers. This is a DIY activity. Stuff like that is a part of it. You have to get your hands dirty. So I'll just insert it properly. Make sure that it's straight. I will add some Fevikwik along the periphery. In the gaps between the adapter. So yeah, this make sure that this component is stuck over here in place. And immediately right after this, I will get towards sticking my adapter. In this also, I will just add some more Fevikwik over here between the adapter and the adapter disc. I can see the gaps from the top. I will show you. I want to do the Fevikwik part quickly so that I can make sure that I get this done before it dries up. Fevikwik is fairly quick drying. So now you can see how this component looks on the inside. And with this, my RB300 has started taking shape. So I am building this rocket without a recovery mechanism. In case you are building a recovery mechanism, you may want to keep two of these components attached only on the top so that this whole adapter assembly can come out. We will be doing another video about recovery mechanisms. Over there we will show how adapters and recovery mechanisms combine. So now there may be some gaps that you may see between your body tube and your adapter. If you've cut your adapter properly, these gaps will be very, very minimal. They're not really a problem. But still, if you want to improve the aerodynamics of your rocket, what you can do is that you can add one layer of electric tape along this edge. So I'm going to do that. In real rockets, where when two stages are connected, there's a ring in between which aligns them properly and keeps the aerodynamics intact. Be very, very careful while using the paper cutter. I say again and again, do not cut your fingers. Young students, do this under adult supervision. So over here we now have the main body structure of the RB300 assembled. So we have the motor housing, the main body structure, fins and the nose cone. So these are practically the complete rocket. So now for the first step, we will go towards assembling these two together. Over here, I have the motor housing with the block ring side. This is the empty side. Block ring side, empty side. I am going to insert the block rings into the body tube. The block rings into the body tube first. So also these parts are supposed to stick together, so I'm going to apply a little bit of Fevikwik as well. So I'm going to insert the block ring side into the body tube. I'll put this completely in. I'll put the second set of rings in just so that they are exactly flush. So this is exactly how your rocket bottom will look like once these two parts are assembled together. So I'll take this out right now and I will start by applying Fevikwik over here, quickly inserting it, then applying Fevikwik on the second set of rings and then putting it into the correct position. Fevikwik is quick drying, so you have to be quick and sharp about it. So you have to ensure that your motor housing is stuck properly with the body tube. It has to be a very, very sturdy structure. So when you press your body tube from the outside on this centering ring, you can feel that structure, and on the second set of centering rings, when you press it like this, you can feel that structure. I can feel that centering ring over here, and inside that the block ring. If I press the body tube over here, it presses, but if I press it over here, it's sturdy and hard. I can feel both set of the rings. I stick them inside properly. In case your rings are a little loose because of, again, tolerance related issues, you can add a layer of electric tape around the ring and make sure that, or you can add a layer of electric tape inside of the body tube. and make sure that it is perfectly fitting. So here we have it. You can look, this is the how the bottom of your rocket will look like. You can see the block rings deep inside, one ring flush. You can see the block ring deep inside, one ring is flush with the bottom. So this is the second segment of the assembly that has been completed. The next step that we shall get onto is attaching the fins of the rocket. So there are four fins that we have given with this rocket. These fins are made out of balsa wood. It's a very, very fragile material. This is the lightest wood in the world. Be very, very careful with it. We have given you one fin sheet in your kit. Over here you can see there is a diagram that has multiple concentric circles. It positions all the fins and it positions the launch lug. If you put your rocket on the top of this, it will align with one of those circles and then you can mark the position of your fins. So I'm going to do that. For that, I'll keep this sheet over here. I will first align my rocket with one of the concentric circles. And now I will mark the position of my fins. So we've given you a pen in the kit. You can use that. With this, I've got the position of all four of the fins that are supposed to go onto my rocket. I'm going to stick these fins onto the rocket using Fevikwik. While sticking the fins, I have to make sure that it is perfectly aligned along the axis of the rocket. The fin has to be perfectly aligned along the axis of the rocket. It should not be tilted like this or tilted like this. It has to be perfectly aligned along the axis of the rocket. At the same time, the correct way to fix the fin is like this. Your leading edge is curved. It is not like this. It is not like this. It is not like this. It is like this. Your leading edge is curved. The leading edge is the edge which cuts through the air. So it's the edge that's going to be facing the air when the rocket is flying up. So it is curved. So you have to fix your fin like this. This is the correct position. So let's get started. I'll start fixing my fins. I'll apply Fevikwik. Yep, and I have my rocket almost taking shape now. So the last thing that we have to do is just lock the nose cone on top, and there you have it, a ready RB300. So this is the Rocketeer's model rocket that was inspired by missiles. As you can see, my nose cone is a little loose over here, so we're going to fix that.
So since you can see that the nose cone is a little loose, what we are going to do is, so we are going to add two layers of, so I could see that it's fairly loose, so I'm going to add three layers of electric tape at the bottom of my nose cone. So when you take the hold of your nose cone, you will see an edge over here. I have added, so you will see an edge over here. So I've added the electric tape just below the edge. And yeah, it's very nice and snug now. So I did not press the rocket down while it was resting on the fins. The fins are very, very fragile. I don't want to put a force on them. So now, as you can see, it's nice and tight. Yep. Perfect. So with this, we've completed the assembly of our RB-300 model rocket. It's a model rocket that Rocketeers built, inspired by missiles. It's actually a very, very evolved model rocket. It started off tiny, it was this big. You'll see photographs of it all over our Instagram. It used to be called RB-300. It was just about 20 centimeters tall. Now this rocket is approximately 50 centimeters tall. It's grown bigger, it's grown more stable, it flies more regally, and it gives an amazing flying experience and an amazing build experience. It's one of the first rockets that we recommend for some older school students, like 11th class students or 12th class students. They would really enjoy building this over a level 1 rocket. This is approximately a level 2 rocket. It's more difficult to build, more difficult to fly, but once you do it properly, it gives you an amazing, stable, regal flight. So with this, we have completed this. The last step that I would like to talk about in this video is fixing a launch lug. So you have also received one straw like this in your kit. So this is called the launch lug. This component is very important. It ensures that your rocket stays connected to the launch pad at the time of launch. It connects the rocket to the launch rod, which is a component on the launch pad, about which we will talk in a lot of detail during our how to fly the model rocket video, which is coming up next. So I'll tell you how to fix the launch lug onto the rocket. For this, you have to cut out two pieces approximately 3 to 4 centimeters long. So I'll cut out two pieces, one and two. I've got them both here. Now on our fin sheet, if you see, there are four positions marked: fin, fin, fin and fin, but there's one position which is marked which says launch lug. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to keep my sheet here. I'm going to align all my fins with the four positions marked as fin, and yeah, and then I will mark the position that says launch lug. But what I'll do is that one mark I will make on the top of the fins, and one mark I will make at this height. So these are the height over here are approximate markings. One is at the top of the fins, which is a fixed position. The launch lug on top may be a little high or maybe a little low. Your rocket would still work fine. If you have added some payload or a recovery mechanism so that your rocket is top heavy, you should add a launch lug nearer to the top side of the rocket. If you have not added any such thing, even if it is nearer to the center, your rocket would work just fine. So I have marked these two positions. So I'm going to start fixing my launch lug, and I'm going to use Fevikwik again. Since the launch lug is also made out of a straw plastic like material, it's very, very difficult to stick onto the body tube. One way to make it easy is to use sandpaper and roughen up your body tube before you start fixing the launch lug. So I'll just do that on the mark. So I've just roughened up this surface. I'm going to put some Fevikwik over here, and I'm going to stick this launch lug. It is very, very important that you make sure that the axis of the launch lug is aligned with the axis of the rocket. They should not be at a separate axis. It should look like that beautiful V, and the axis of the rocket and the axis of the launch lug should be the same. Now I'll repeat the same process on the top side,
and I'll apply some glue very quick, and quickly
please be extremely careful while fixing the second launch lug. This is even more difficult than the first one because you have to align it with the axis and then you have to align the two launch lugs together themselves. So as you can see, they're aligned properly together and we fix the two launch lugs, and with this we have completed the assembly of the RB300 model rocket. You can buy this on our website. I've already told you about the link in the description below. We'll be talking about how to fly this in our next video. And I hope you guys enjoyed yourself, and till then, stay nuts about rockets.